from military parades to religious processions. Colorful floats to marching bands. Beauty queens to circus clowns. New Bedford loves a parade. According to the History of New Bedford by Zephariah Pease, the city's first parade was July 4, 1847, in celebration of Independence Day and New Bedford's incorporation. Led by the New Bedford Guards, the parade included Mayor Abraham Howland, other city officials, and members of several civic groups. The city would go on to celebrate its 50th anniversary in 1897. In 1947, the centennial celebration featured a large parade with floats, marching bands, and beauty queens, among others. From that point forward, parades became a major part of New Bedford family life.
There's no two ways about it. I think when you were young, you looked forward for New Bedford and the parade. Whether you lived in a small town, regardless where you lived, New Bedford was the place to be, because that's where the parades were.
The parade was a major event. It was free. We could walk downtown. We lived in the West End, but relatively, if you lived in the South End, it was relatively easy to get there. You could walk there. You could go with your entire family. After the parade, you could hang around downtown. There were always things to do. If you were lucky, you might have had enough money to go to the peanut store or to go buy a soda at the 5 and 10 cent store. But it was an event that you looked forward to, especially because it kind of marked summer. You knew that summer was coming when you had the Memorial Day parade. So you really looked forward to that. So it was a very special time.
The annual Memorial Day parade honors veterans who died while in military service. The 1895 parade honored Civil War veterans from GAR Post 190.
Everybody dressed up in their best to go to the Memorial Day parade. And so you walked around in your finery downtown, and then when you came back home, you didn't just come in and change. You still kind of strutted around a little bit to show everybody your new finery. So it was, and it was Memorial Day was, of course, there was the aspect of the holiday itself. Trips to the cemetery, and people would put flowers on the grave. So it was a day-long celebration. It's not like today where a lot of people think of it as just a day off of school or a day off of work. It was a holiday that everybody celebrated in their own way.
When I was a child, the first parade I ever saw was, you know, I was connected with the Our Lady of Assumption Church and the Ultramarine Band Club. And at that time, other churches were also involved, as well as the Santo Cristo Club. And so it was very interesting because they had a great deal of music in the parades as they paraded around. and everyone seemed to be having a great time. And so it was the first parade that I saw as a child, and after that I took a liking to parades and kept watching parades whenever I could, because I thought it was very nice, and it showed a lot of solidarity and people getting together.
The church parade from the band club and to Wellaway Church to the cemetery, that was, that might have been my first parade, but anyway, that was the next big move, was to actually participate in that parade. I think it was communion, dressed up in the suits and going off to the cemetery. I started to get it real quick. You know, we're going to show up all dressed up in our communion costumes, our uniform, our outfits, and then we're going to meet at the church, and a band was going to come up the street from the band club, and we were all going to proceed up to the cemetery. And it wasn't until I actually got to the cemetery, as young as I was, that I realized why we were here, why we were at the cemetery, what was all this about, why was everybody crying, you know? And that slow walk into the cemetery, that drum line, that muffled drum going into the cemetery, half-stepping, side to side. Yes. And the guns going off at the gravesite, and people speaking. Then we're all gonna go back to the vet's hall and have something to eat.
We'd march from the vets to St. John's Cemetery and back. So that was one parade. Then we leave there and go uptown and do the parade in town. So it seemed like it was the thing to do.
There was a parade on Pleasant Street. I say Pleasant Street, I'm just using it as a reference point. It was a huge parade, and I don't know what ever happened. I don't remember when it was. I believe it was in late 50s. It was a huge parade. I remember that, sometimes I look at old videos of parades in New Bedford and I wonder, am I watching the one that I was at? But once again, I was very young, but it was a huge parade, and I do remember being on Pleasant Street watching it. You know, back in the day, people came out for parades, so, you know, for a long time, parade routes were always jammed with people, and they appreciated, we appreciated parades, you know? And, you know, the Veterans Day parades, the Memorial Day parades, the special celebrations, you know, Moby Dick and all that coming to the State Theater, that is.
Gregory Peck arrives in New Bedford for the world premiere of Warner Brothers' Moby Dick. The old whaling museum and the bearded townspeople seem warmly familiar to Peck, who plays Captain Ahab in Herman Melville's classic American novel. Also attending the premiere is producer-director John Huston. A 7-mile-long parade, biggest in New Bedford history, highlights the 3 days of festivities. Moby Dick, which also stars Leo Genn, Richard Basehart, and Orson Welles, was photographed in a spectacular new Technicolor process. Opening simultaneously at 3 New Bedford theaters, it is the story of the great white whale, Moby Dick. To kill that whale, which had already taken one of his legs, Captain Ahab is driven to a voyage of pursuit and revenge. An unforgettable motion picture, Warner Brothers' Moby Dick.
The premiere of Moby Dick, I was, I'm not sure, maybe 11, 12 years old, something like that. That was a big, big deal because I loved Gregory Peck. I was one of those kids that just thought, you know, Gregory Peck was the cat's meow. And I convinced my poor brother Danny to go downtown with me, and there were so many people. It was a huge event. And my brother said, "You're never gonna get close enough to see Gregory Peck." And I was bound and determined. So I crawled under a lot of people's legs, and I came up right in front of his car that stopped in front of the post office. He was in a convertible top, and car, open convertible car, and I was standing right in front of Mr. Peck, just grinning away with my long braids, and he leaned over and he shook my hand, and that was it. I just about lost it. But I remember that day very, very well, and there were some other stars. John Huston was there, and Aldo Reyes, a few other people, I think. But Gregory Peck was, that was it.
Then you went 2 months without washing your hands.
Absolutely.
Armistice Day was first established in 1919 and honored all World War I veterans. It was later renamed Veterans Day to honor all veterans, living and dead, from all wars.
Thank you.
One of the most popular city parades is the Cape Verdean Recognition Parade. First held in 1974, the parade is held in July and attracts visitors from across the country.
It was a way of kind of saying, we're here, we've been here for a long, long time. And I think that the community at large, not just the Cape Verdean community, the community at large came to really look forward to the Cape Verdean parade. Everybody was Cape Verdean for that one day. Event that people look forward to, Cape Verdean Recognition, Cape Verdean Independence Recognition Parade. It's taken on a whole different meaning today, but nonetheless valuable, but also a sense of pride in the community that's been established here for so long and been part of New Bedford.
A second major parade is the Feast of the Blessed Sacrament Parade, held each year in August.
They start at Brooklawn Park.
Yeah.
And they end up on Earl Street.
Yep.
They've got just about anything and everybody is in that parade.
That's right.
Yeah.
I know they line that up, is, they right up Brooklawn Street.
Brooklawn Park, yeah.
Right up Brooklawn Park. Up to Ashley Boulevard.
Almost to the Boulevard.
Right down, and then they turn right at the corner of the park and then they head down to Earl Street.
Yeah, that is a big
parade today.
The time that they put into that and the Cape Verdean Parade are the two largest parades. first parade I've ever seen, this goes back to the 40s, the early 40s. Back then, Acushnet Avenue was really, really big. The South End had their parades, North End had their parades, and naturally, downtown had their parades. And the parades would go from, I guess, Wells Street is where it would start and would go over to Brooklawn Park. And the kids were kids back then. And that was a big thing to see parades. We had parades when the circus came to town.
Remember they set up off of where the Ashley Ford eventually was built, up near Brittonwood.
Yeah.
And that was a big, big empty lot.
There were the small circuses that would come into town, the carnivals that would come into town. But Barnum and Bailey, when they were coming into town, it was splattered all over the newspaper. I mean, it was big.
I will tell you one thing, and tradition will prove it, and if you look back at all the archives, New Bedford loves a parade.
It certainly does. And I still love it.
Thank you. Thank you.